In this video, we are going to take a look at the cash flow statement of our favorite company, Reliance Industries Limited, yet again. We will look at the format, the template which is used by the companies, and we'll look at the details, we'll look at the content which are shown, we'll look at the activities, the transactions which are shown under the operating, investing and financing activities. Let us get started. I have on the screen the cash flow statement from the same annual report which we have been using in this course. So right after the balance sheet and income statement, you will see the third statement, which is cash flow statement. The statement is for the year ended 31st March 2019, and since it says it is for a year, it explains to you the transactions during that year. So it's a flow concept in that sense. All right, there are three broad heads using which this report is prepared. You have A, B and C. If you see clearly, if you can see the screen, and I'll zoom into each of these. First of all, you have cash flows from operating activities. The second head is cash flows from investing activities, and third is cash flow from financing activities. So all we've done is we've categorized the transactions into these three, and then we are saying, as a result of all the operating activities which are shown here, what is the net cash that you get or you pay? Again, cash flow from investing activities, what is the net cash flow as a result of investing activities, and what is the net cash flow as a result of financing activities? And finally, you have the as a result of all three categories, what happens to the cash, which is shown here. Now let us go to each of these sections one by one. We'll look at the operating activities first. This is a zoom in version of the first section, section A. What is it? So it starts with net profit before tax as per the statement of profit and loss. So as I said earlier, cash flow statement is prepared using the data from the final accounts. So in that sense, this is an analytical statement and less a final account statement. So the net profit before and before interest and tax is being adjusted for a number of things. What are these things is something that we will discuss, but to give you a quick idea, you have depreciation. Depreciation is a non-cash transaction. You have gain on financial asset, which is non-operating transaction. You have finance cost, which is also a non-operating transaction, or specifically we know it to be a finance activity. So finance. Interest income is a non-operating income. Dividend income is also a non-operating income. All right, and if you have to specifically point out these, both of these are investing activities. So both of these are a result of investing activities of the business. You are receiving income as dividend or interest on the investments made in deposits or in the shares of other companies. Then you have effect of exchange rate changes. Just ignore this. This is a little bit more complex international company. We don't have to worry about that right now. So in the first section, what is really happening is there are some adjustments which are being made for non-cash and non-operating activities. All right. If you remember, in the income statement, we do not worry about showing only operating. We also show non-operating. So in this first section of cash flow statement, we are making adjustment to the net profit during the year. What are the adjustments being made? Adjustments are being made for the non-cash and non-operating items. Okay, just remember that. And of course, we are going to deep dive into these things and learn to prepare this section as well. The next section here shows operating profit before working capital changes, and then it is adjusted for trade and other receivables, inventories and other payables. So you have current assets and current liabilities. Both of these taken together give you a sense of working capital. working capital, and hence it says operating profit before working capital changes. Now this number is received after the adjustments above. This is the number, and then you make some more adjustments due to working capital. What is working capital? It has current assets and current liabilities. Current assets says trade receivables. Have you received money from the customers? Have you purchased more stock? Have you paid to your vendors? All these are also operating activities of the business. So these are also being adjusted for in this first section. And then you have the cash generated from operations, and then you pay taxes on it. You see taxes are being shown separately here. Taxes are paid, and finally you arrive at a number which is called net cash flow from operating activities. This is nothing new. We are familiar with all the items being shown here except for one odd advance item which we're not going to discuss at all. So this is the first section. We are familiar with the terms. All we have to understand in this statement, in this section of the statement, is why are these adjustments being made and what is the outcome of these adjustments. So hold on for that. In the following videos I will do that. Let's go to the second section, which is about the investing activities of the business. So let me zoom in. These are the investing activities. Now if you remember, we said investing activities are about purchase of assets, sale of assets, purchase of an investment of in a financial instrument, or sale of that, or any income resulting from these financial instruments in which investment has been made. So let us look at Reliance Industries cash flows from investing activities during the financial year 1920. So we have purchase of property, plant, equipment and intangible assets. Purchases are being made of fixed assets. Yes, this is an investing activities. You have proceeds. Proceeds are basically inflows, the cash that you get. It's a technical term used for the money that you get. Proceeds from sale of goods, proceed from sale of asset, such. This term is used as such. So proceed from disposal of property. So now you are selling the property, you are showing it here. Then you have investment in subsidiaries or trusts. So money is being invested by the company. Reliance has a lot of subsidiary companies. Subsidiary company basically means that Reliance starts another company and holds all the shares in that company, or most of the shares in that company. So one company investing in another company. This is the relationship between a subsidiary company and the holding company. That's another new term that I introduced here. Holding is the parent company, the one which invests in its child company, which is subsidiary company. So this is an investment. Then you have disposal of investment. Disposal basically means sales. You have disposed of your investments in subsidiary company and made some money. Then you have purchase of any other investments, proceeds from sale of financial assets there, net cash flows from other financial assets. So there are, financial and other financial, maybe this is due to the quantity of money total which is invested in these assets and these assets, but doesn't matter. If you go to the financial statements, the balance sheet and income statement, you'll figure out the details of this as well. Then you have interest income, which you earn on the various investments that you've made. You have dividend income from associates. Associates possibly are the subsidiary companies associated with the Reliance Industries. And then you have dividend income from any other sources. There you go. All of these, some of these are cash inflows, some are cash outflows. So outflows are shown in brackets. Brackets mean negative. So these are outflows and these are inflows. Inflows and inflows. And then total of all of this comes out to be a negative number. So net net, you have an outflow. So net cash flow used. Used means outflow. Used in investing activities. So Reliance Industries Limited during this financial year has used up about 57.5 crores. The units are in crores. This much money has been used in the investing activities. Where has it been used? Well, it has been used in purchase of fixed assets investing in other subsidiary companies, purchase of some other investments, and spent money in the financial assets as well. So there you go. This is the second section of the cash flow statement of Reliance Industries Limited. We do not see any special terms here. There were a couple of new terms, subsidiary, holding company, associates. I've explained those, so nothing to be worried about. Let's go on to the third section, the final section of the statement, which is cash flow from financing activities. Cash flow from financing activities shows proceeds from issue of equity share capital. Proceed again refers to the cash that you receive from a transaction. So you are issuing, the Reliance is issuing equity shares. So they issued some equity shares and they got 117 crores in return. This is an inflow. Share application money. So share application money refers to, so when the company offers shares to public, issues share to public, there are steps which are followed. The first step is to apply for shares. Who applies for shares? Well, a company is issuing shares to public, let's say. So if you want to subscribe to the share, you have to apply. So an application is sent to the company, and this is typically online application. Now you can't just send an application, you have to also submit an application money. Just like, you know, if you are preparing for any exams, you submit the registration fee for the exam to register. It's just an entry barrier so that you know, not everybody starts registering, and then on the day of the exam we prepare seating arrangement for 1,000 people but only 100 show up. So if you pay, then you are more likely to come. Likewise, the companies, if the share is worth, let's say, 100 rupees per unit, then they say, okay, please pay 20% of this. So 20 per share is the application money. So that money is given to the company, and company treats that as an inflow, and that is what is shown here. Share application money has been received. So 117 is the actual shares issued, and 2 crores is the share application money which is with the business. Alright, let's move forward. You have proceeds from borrowings, non-current. Non-current is long-term borrowings, we know. So you have raised some long-term loan. Then you repay some long-term previous loans you must have paid. Then you have borrowings, current. These are short-term loans being raised. And then you have dividend that is being paid. So dividend is paid on the equity shares that the company has. So again, this is a financing activity. And any interest paid on the loans that the company has. So that's it. This is the end of the section, and you have 25 crores, which are cash flows. This is a positive number. So cash flow from financing activities. The financing activities involved raising of capital, raising some loan, and then paying some dividend and interest thereon. Net net, you are receiving, you are making cash through the financing activities of the business. That's it. That's the third section of the cash flow statement. And then you have these three lines, which are the, you know, after the third section ends. So what is happening here is, let me first explain that to you, and then you should look at these. So there are three activities. You have operating activities, and you have investing and financing. Investing and financing. As a result of operating activities, let's say you make some cash, 50 plus 50. In the investing activities, you are spending the cash. In financing activities, you are making some cash. Okay. What is the net result? The net result is A plus B plus C. In through all the activities, what happened here is that you made 50 plus 10, 60, and you spent 40. So net net, during the year, cash equal to 40 has come into the business. All right. This is the net cash inflow during the year. All right. Now, if this is the cash inflow during the year, we are talking about a financial year 2019. So 19 and financial year 2020. 20. So in financial year 2019, maybe let me take a date. Let's say April, let me write it here. So April 1st in 2019, and now we are at 2020, March 31st. This is the financial year. So when you started the year in 2019, April 1st, first day of the financial year, you had cash equivalent to 100 in the books of accounts, in the bank account of the company, 100. And at the end of the year, you have 140, all right? What is the change? The change is plus 40, all right? Why this change? This change is resulted due to these three items. 50 came in, 20 went out, 10 came in. Net-net, 40 came in, and that is shown here. So exactly the same thing is being shown here. You have net increase during the year. Okay, this is your 40. All right. Opening balance of cash was 100. And the final balance at the end of the year is 140. That's it. That's the last part, the conclusion of the cash flow statement. Now, this conclusion, these two balances can be easily seen in the balance sheet. Balance sheet already shows you this. What we did was we broke this 40 down into these three components. That's the purpose of the cash flow statement. The purpose is to explain the reasons of change. The reasons are categorized into three, and the outcome of each of these three reasons is given in each of these three sections, and you're done with the cash flow statement. All right, so in this video, I took you through the actual statement of a real company. And what we have seen is none of these items are something which we don't know about. We've already discussed all these items. We are just using another technique to categorize the information, the data in the balance sheet and income statement, and coming up with new kind of information. All right, I'll see you in the next video.